Did you know an egg is considered a perfect protein and is the single best source of high biological value protein in the world? I thought you should know. Hi guys, welcome to Kijani Farmstead. We are Sel. In this channel, we share all our adventure in the farmstead. We are all about farm, food, and fun. In today's video, we share with you how to make a local backyard poultry farming a profitable venture. As you may know, there are different types of chicken reared in Kenya, Kienyeji chicken being the most common. Kienyeji chicken come in different breeds, namely dominant Kienyeji, curry improved Kienyeji, Kuroiler improved, rainbow rooster, Sasso chicken, and Kendro chicken. At Kijani Farmstead, we keep the dominant Kienyeji chicken in addition to other poultry, that is the ducks, geese, and turkeys. To maximize poultry production, we concentrate our effort in these five aspects. One being the poultry housing, feeding and general nutrition of our birds, hygiene practices in the coop, which is linked to the health of these birds, laying and brooding, and of course, the dollar. We sell and consume this chicken and eggs to reduce our protein cost and also to bring some profit home. Let's start with the housing and structure. Here we opted for cemented houses for the poultry because they are easy to clean and disinfect. We ensure the houses are well ventilated to allow clean air circulation. We have provided perching areas in the houses for the birds to roost at night and even during the day on the wet seasons. Funny enough, the big birds prefer roosting on the rafters up high. We have provided laying boxes for the birds, and these boxes we make them by ourselves. In these boxes we add sawdust, which we obtain from our woodworks in the farmstead, and sometimes we obtain from the local carpenters. We have also built small cages within the main house as well as outside, like the one here, where the chicks, poults, and duckling are kept. These cages ensure that special care and attention is given to the new birds to ensure their health and survival. We have also made these incubating boxes for the birds for natural incubation process. As you can see, they come in different shapes, sizes, and heights. We wanted to ensure each bird has the best nests. Please check our DIY video linked below. We have demarcated the enclosure with chain link to separate the birds so that they do not fight and also to safeguard them against the predators. Within the enclosure, there is adequate supply of piped water, as you can see. This water is used for cleaning and also for the poultry to drink. And there is also provision of a pool to be used by the geese and the ducks to swim. Number two, let's look at feeding and nutrition. In the morning, we normally release the birds for them to walk freely around the compound and feed on insects and grass. Some of them even opt to play in the dust. After around an hour, they get back to the enclosure where they are served their morning feeds. Please check our DIY video on how we make dry and wet feeders. Feeding is done 2 times a day, that is in the morning and afternoon. During feeding, the young chicks are fed separately. This is to avoid competition and also to ensure that all birds are well fed. We normally buy the commercial feeds, and sometimes we make our own combination of carbohydrates and protein feeds available. The food is accompanied by green vegetables and sometimes fruits like the bananas and papayas, which we obtain from our farm. We always provide clean water for the chicken throughout the day. At this point, if you have not subscribed, you risk to be chased by this male turkey. Let's go to hygiene and diseases. Kienyeji chicken are known to be hardy and resistant to diseases. Some of the best practices that we do at Kijani Farmstead include the following. Number one is to have a foot bath at the entrance to eliminate spread of diseases causing parasites such as mites, lice, bugs, fleas, and even ticks. Number two, cleaning the houses and the environment. Here we normally disinfect by use of ash from the kitchen and doo doo dust like the sieving. Number three, cleaning the feeders and drinkers daily and changing the water, as well as clearing the food remains frequently as needed. We also change the water for the swimmers, that is the small pool for the swimming poultry. Number five is storing the food in a cool, dry place to avoid contamination. Number six, cleaning the vegetables before serving the poultry. Number seven, disposing the dead birds quickly and also isolate the sick ones. Number eight, we occasionally add aloe vera, pepper, and cinnamon to make to the chicken drinks. This is a herbal preparation. Number nine, timely identification, treatment, and management of common illness, such as coccidiosis. Other practices include, which are recommended include deworming, vaccination against Newcastle disease. Lastly, number 10 is consulting a veterinarian whenever we encounter unusual diseases. Characteristics of sick birds are like dullness, low feeding, low water intake, low egg production, and sometimes rough skin. Number four, let's look at laying and brooding. The original or dominant Kienyeji chicken is the pure breed of indigenous chicken, not adulterated by research. They are reared both mostly for eggs and meats. Most Kienyeji birds lay average of 3 to 10 eggs per month. However, at Kijani Farmstead, with good nutrition and care, we have been able to double the egg production. Our turkeys and ducks lay over 10 eggs per reproduction cycle, but this varies depending on the breed. We will share in another episode on the breeds of ducks available. On the other hand, geese lay 30 to 50 eggs per year, depending also on the breed. We pick eggs daily and store them in trays in cool places to keep them at optimal quality for consumption and also for incubation. It's advisable not to store the eggs in the kitchen or on top of cupboards, as the heat may partially incubate the eggs and kill the embryo. At Kijani, we have set designated houses for the different birds for laying and for brooding, as well as spaces for the chicks. Our various brooding boxes come in handy when it comes to incubation. Let's look at marketing and record keeping. You as the farmer should be the first customer. So here at Kijani Farmstead, instead of buying meats and eggs, we get them from the farm and save the money for our other needs. There is high demand in the market for both eggs and meats from Kienyeji chicken and other poultry. As for us, we sell live birds to our clients mostly because they buy from the farmstead. For production and continuity, we select and reserve the best birds, that is the best brooders and the best cocks. We also change the cock frequently to prevent inbreeding. On record keeping, we take stock of the following to ensure sustainability. That is the number of eggs produced and eggs hatched, quantity of feeds eaten, sales and purchases, health interventions, and even the number of deaths encountered. Hope you find this useful. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe, like, and share. Bye.